So you just finished editing your whole video in DaVinci Resolve, you're psyched out of your mind, you hit the deliver tab, and all of a sudden you're met with all these crazy export settings that you have no idea what to do. Don't freak out, don't freak out. You clicked on the right video. In this video, I'm gonna share with you the best settings for rendering your videos in 1080p, 4K, and that sweet, sweet 4K widescreen that takes up the entire phone. Coming up.
First, if you're new here, hit the subscribe button and the bell notification to be updated on the newest videos put out and to stay part of the conversation.
Now that we're in the export tab, or called the deliver tab, I just call it the little rocket ship. This is where you're going to export every single piece of content. What you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna hit this drop down arrow. This is going to just reveal all of these settings right here. Don't be worried about messing up anything on your timeline. You can grab it, you can drag it, it won't do anything. This is just showing all the things that you have. The only thing you can do on this is set in and out points. So in, out, that's all you can do. And this will just be like, you want to render this section right here, but that's not why you're here. You are here for the best rendering settings for YouTube. So let's do that right now. A lot of people will use this YouTube 1080p, and the YouTube 1080p has the ability to go up to 4K and even to 8K, which is wild. And then you can choose your formats. You can do only MP4, QuickTime, all that stuff, but it's not my choice, right? Some people like it because it's simple. I personally use custom because I like to know all the settings that are in this. I like to change my bitrate, the depth. If you want something just quick and simple, go ahead, do YouTube, but it will not be the best. Go over here into custom section. This is where we really get into like the good settings. First of all, add a file name. You need to know what you're doing. This is a test. Location, know where you're gonna put your clips. If you lose it, that sucks. I've totally lost stuff before and had to like search far and wide for it. So now we're actually into the settings. The next area is this render section. It's right now it's a set on single clip, which we want because this whole timeline will render out as one movie. Individual clip will render out every single clip. So if you made a cut in a few sections, it'll render out each one of those areas as its own clip. Now this could be good for like Premiere Pro if you wanna like do color grade in here and then export it to Premiere Pro and finish your edit over there, all that stuff. For this tutorial, we're gonna do single clip. Next, we're gonna go down to format. The standard for YouTube is MP4. QuickTime is a good format, but the files tend to be super big. So if you were rendering QuickTime and upload to YouTube, 5-minute video might be 15 gigabytes, and that's a lot of space. You really don't wanna have to upload all that. Like, that's just a lot of time. Go to MP4, MP4 is a good format, and then on H.264 for your codec, leave that. H.264 is a compressed codec, so that's what we're gonna pick, because you don't want a massive, massive file. And then for encoder, leave it the same, leave it native. Then here's where we change our resolution. So for the examples, we're going to do 1920 by 1080, leave that. Your frame rate, leave that. And then you see this quality right here. It's normally on automatic. For you, it should be on automatic. You have all these options. We have best, high, medium, low, and least. I don't think you should do any of these. I mean, you can do best. It will do a good job. But I personally choose to restrict to a certain amount. Now it's set at 10,000 kilobytes a second. YouTube has a crazy, crazy compression. So if you were to render it out right now, it would look good, but then you upload it to YouTube and it kind of looks, it's not as good, it's not as crisp, it's not as clear. So what we're gonna do to kind of counteract that is we're gonna grab this and we're gonna multiply it by 3. So we're going to just drag it up to 30,000. It doesn't have to be exactly there. Then for encoding profile, leave auto, and everything else should be good. In advanced settings, just make sure it's on square, the pixel aspect ratio, data levels, all that stuff, it should be good. Audio, make sure it's on AAC. I mean, there's really nothing else there, so I don't know what you'd put it. Keep your bitrate for your audio up, and you should be good. Now what we're gonna do is we're just gonna hit add to render queue, and it pops up over here. So before you leave, now we're gonna render out in 4K. A few settings actually do change in this, so really stay tuned to this. So we're gonna leave everything the same, like our format, our codec, our encoder, but our resolution, we're gonna change to Ultra HD, which is 3840 by 2160, and then we're gonna take our quality, and we're gonna multiply that pretty much by 3 times. So just Bring it on up, keep it going. You feel that? That's your storage being eaten up. Yeah, look at that number going up. I like to go about 100,000, and then everything is gonna stay the same. You're gonna hit add to render queue, and I'm just gonna do that. Hit okay. So for your 4K widescreen, that's like the resolution that like fills up your whole phone screen natively. You don't have to like zoom in on it. You're not gonna have any weird loss of quality or even loss of image. So what you're gonna do for this is they don't actually have it under settings or under a preset. So you're just gonna make it yourself, right? You're gonna do 3840 by 1920. Everything else is gonna stay the same. And you're gonna hit add to render queue. And there it is. And that's it. That is how you export your awesome video in DaVinci Resolve and keep the best quality. In the comments below, let me know if this has helped or if you actually figured out a better way to export videos to YouTube. But as usual, the video on top is the top 5 features in DaVinci Resolve 16.1. Check that out, they're sick. And the video on bottom is a video that YouTube thinks that you would like. Anyway, until the next one, peace.